Concrete must be a minimum of 2 inches thick. Concrete must be clean, dry, and free of grease, paint, oil, dust, curing agents, or any foreign material that will prevent proper adhesion. Slope must be a minimum of 1/4 inch per linear foot to allow for proper drainage. The concrete should be at least 2500 PSI, porous, and able to absorb water. A minimum of 28 days curing time is required on all concrete. All concrete should be tested for moisture before applying a seamless coating. If moisture emissions exceed 5 pounds per 1,000 square feet, or if the relative humidity exceeds 75%, please refer to the EC15 Moisture Vapor Barrier Product Specification Sheet. Prepare concrete to a profile equal to CSP3 as specified by International Concrete Repair Institute. Cracks greater than 1/32 of an inch should be routed 1/4 by 1/4 inch. For crack treatment, install WP-47A seam tape over all cracks and seams. With the EC-72 epoxy patch gel, mix both parts A and B, then apply the EC-72 into the tape with a trowel or putty knife to smooth, and broadcast with 30 grit silica sand to allow adhesion of the coating. Allow EC-72 3 to 4 hours to cure before the next coat. Westcoat requires a minimum of 26 gauge bonderized sheet metal. Mix 1 part A and 1 part B of EC-72. Combine using a mechanical mixer at a low RPM or stir stick. Mix slowly for 3 to 5 minutes or until completely combined. Flashing should be set in a bed of EC-72 and nailed only as needed. Overlap all seams at least 4 inches. Caulk between overlapped flashing as well as the seam with WP-51 polyurethane sealant. Nail only as needed. If the flashing is not bonderized, please contact your Westcoat representative. Lay out the WP-47H fiberlath reinforcing mesh onto the deck. Lay the lath curl side down on the deck. Overlap the seams approximately 2 inches. Combine 1 bag of TC1 base coat cement with 5 gallons of WP90 waterproofing resin. Mix until uniform with a mechanical mixer at a low RPM. Pour the mixture into the WP-47H, trowel thin and smooth at the coverage rate of 220 to 260 square feet. Use a paintbrush to spread the base coat on the flashing, making sure to get the mixture into the seams and corners. As soon as the resin membrane is dry, typically 1 to 4 hours at 70 degrees Fahrenheit, scrape high spots or ridges as needed before applying the slurry coat. Combine 1 bag of TC1 base coat cement with 5 gallons of WP90 waterproofing resin. Mix until uniform with a mechanical mixer at a low RPM. Trowel the entire surface smooth and as thin as possible, approximately 250 to 320 square feet per batch. After the surface has dried, typically up to 30 minutes to an hour at 70 degrees, lightly scrape any trowel marks and vacuum the surface clean before applying the top coat. Mix all containers of SC10 acrylic top coat to ensure a consistent color for the entire project. If additional skid resistance is required, Westcoat Safe Grips can be added to produce a skid-resistant finish and reduce slip hazards. Roll 2 thin applications of SC10 using a 3/4 inch roller at a rate of 200 to 300 square feet per gallon. Roll the material in 2 directions to achieve a uniform finish. Coverage will vary according to texture. For best results, allow SC10 4 to 6 hours drying time at 70 degrees before allowing light pedestrian traffic or applying additional coats. Allow 24 hours to cure before heavy traffic. Allow 48 hours before heavy objects are placed on the surface. And those are the steps to install the MACoat Standard Finish System. Optional texture coats can be applied over the slurry coat if additional waterproofing, durability, or enhanced skid resistance is desired. If a smooth texture is desired to provide additional waterproofing and durability, mix 1 bag of TC1 base coat cement to to 5 gallons of WP90 waterproofing resin. Trowel the entire surface smooth at the rate of approximately 300 to 350 square feet per batch. After the surface has dried, typically up to 30 minutes to an hour at 70 degrees, lightly scrape any trowel marks and vacuum the surface clean before applying the top coat. Mix all containers of SC10 acrylic top coat to ensure a consistent color for the entire project. Roll 2 thin applications of SC10 using a 3/4-inch roller at a rate of 200 to 300 square feet per gallon. Roll the material in 2 directions to achieve a uniform finish. Allow SC10 to dry at 4 to 6 hours at 70 degrees before allowing light pedestrian traffic or applying additional coats. If the knockdown texture is desired for additional protection and for enhanced skid resistance, pour 1 gallon of WP81 cement modifier in a clean mixing bucket and add 1 bag of TC3 medium texture cement. Mix thoroughly with a mechanical mixer at a low RPM. Add up to a 1/2 gallon of water to achieve desired consistency. Using an acoustical hopper gun, spray the texture onto the deck with a circular motion to achieve approximately 70% coverage at a rate of about 150 to 200 square feet per batch. Spray continuously. Do not stop in the middle of the deck. After a few minutes, depending on the temperature, the texture must be knocked down using a crazy trowel or a rounded pool trowel. After the surface has dried, typically up to 30 minutes to an hour at 70 degrees, lightly scrape any trowel marks and vacuum the surface clean before applying the top coat. Mix all containers of SC10 acrylic top coat to ensure a consistent color for the entire project. Roll 2 thin applications of SC10 using a 3/4-inch roller at a rate of 200 to 300 square feet per gallon. Roll the material in 2 directions to achieve a uniform finish. Allow SC10 to dry at 4 to 6 hours at 70 degrees before allowing light pedestrian traffic or applying additional coats. For more information on the MACoat Standard System, please call us at 1-800-250-4519 or email us at info@westcoat.com or feel free to visit our website at www.westcoat.com.